Senate Bill 5 clears another hurdle. It passes the Senate and is now on its way to the Iowa House.
Let's get right to News Channel 5's John Kosick in Columbus. And John, the vote could not have been any closer and certainly has thousands of union members unhappy tonight.
Definitely, indeed, Lee. You can hear some of them behind me. The Senate Republicans may hold a 23-10 majority in the Senate, but this thing came down to the wire, 17-16, to essentially overhaul, if not throw out, some would say, the 1983 collective bargaining rights bill here in the state, a day that started with drama, ended with drama. When the Senate Insurance, Commerce, and Labor Committee voted to approve Senate Bill 5 this morning, they did so after replacing a Republican member opposed to the bill with one who supports it.
Was it because of the way he was going to vote?
That would be my assumption. I'll defer to Tom Niehaus on those issues.
Niehaus being the Senate president who Democrats say ordered the switch.
And I have to ask the question, is this politics or politricks? It seems like a lot of politricks in my mind.
Cleveland State Senator Nina Turner among those upset with the move that sent the bill to the full Senate this afternoon for a vote. Where among those speaking out against it was a Republican senator pulled from the committee, as well as Chesterland Republican Tim Grendel, who told the body the bill doesn't reform collective bargaining. It scraps it altogether.
There is no collective bargaining process. Senate Bill 5 replaces public worker collective bargaining with public worker collective begging.
And Senate Bill 5 once again overhauls the collective bargaining law, affects 350,000 state and local union employees in Ohio, allowing them to negotiate pretty much wages and not much else beyond that. The vote would have been a little bit wider, Grendel says, if they had just simply kept police and firefighters out of this like the state of Wisconsin did. Governor Kasich a short while ago issuing a statement offering his thanks to the Senate leaders for passing Senate Bill 5, a bill that he says will give both the state and local municipalities the tools that they need to weather the financial storm that is ahead, because in 2 weeks he will reveal his budget, and this is just one part of a multi-part platform that will call for reforming not only the unions in the state, but as well as the education system, the prisons, as well as Medicaid. Reporting live in Columbus, John Kosick, News Channel 5.
So, John, the bill is in the House now. No doubt, as we can hear, the protests will continue. Any idea how soon that vote might come?
I tried to get a hold of State Representative Bill Batchelder in Medina, the state speaker, to see when they might be coming up. It'll be fairly quickly, I can say that for sure, and the Republicans feel that they have their votes. And that's a concern, as Tim Grendel pointed out to me just a couple of minutes ago. He feels that this will pass, and this will end up on the ballot in November, and 85% of the bill that he agreed with, that he thought was good, is going to end up possibly getting thrown out if the voters in Ohio decide to throw the whole bill out in November. Reporting live in Columbus, John Kosick, News Channel 5.